Hi everyone, I just want to introduce myself. My name's Dean. I'm talking to you from Lake House Arts right here in Takapuna. I am the tutor here in charge of cartoon character design and illustration. I come from a background of animation. I worked for Disney many, many years ago as an animator, and worked on such shows as Timon and Pumbaa from The Lion King, Duck Days with Donald Duck, and another one called Tex Tin Star, just to name a few. From there, I've progressed on to teaching, clearly, and I just want to give you some basics today on what I do when I'm starting to create my own characters, where I go to. So the very first thing that I want to talk about is research. You must research your characters, and research these days is quite easy because we've got such a lot of things that we can do with Google and other formats that we can look up different images and start to get some references from those. Now, when I'm talking about that, we're not actually going out and we're copying each image. We're just getting some ideas from a variety of different images and bringing them together to create our own characters. Now, I usually start off with a fairly good idea of what I want in my head. For instance, recently I was thinking of doing a story based on one of my ancestors. He was a very interesting character. His name was Ignatius Soares. He was Portuguese and he was a sea captain. He actually ran the scows that used to travel around the North Island delivering all the goods to the little settlements up and down there. In the island. But he had a nickname. His nickname was Tiger, so he was known as Captain Tiger Soas, is the English version. So let's get into it. Let's have a look. I'm going to go now to share screen, and that way we'll be able to bring up this image here. Now, this isn't Captain Tiger himself. Unfortunately, I didn't have any photos of the man himself. None that I could find, but the stories I heard from my grandmother about her dad sort of led me believe that he was something that looked like this guy. So I found this image on Google, but what I'm going to do is just going to recreate my character, draw this guy first, and then I'm going to recreate this character, putting some of the ideas in that I think my character needs. All right, so I've done a little bit of work earlier, so I'll show you what I've done so far. Let's see if I can find it now. There we go. All right. Now I've got a pen, let's just make sure that it's working. I can't draw on that, so I need another layout. Let's try that. There we go. Oh, it's a nice big blue one. That's a bit too big, so I'll just take that back a bit. And make that a bit skinnier. I'll draw in black too, I think. I don't think I'll do blue. Alright, so when I'm creating a character, when I'm first drawing this figure, I'm trying to do a reasonable reproduction of them, but I'm looking for the shapes. So the first shape that I'm looking for is that spherical shape that's going to tell me basically where the cranium, the top of his head, the top of his skull is going to go. Now that cranium will finish basically around the bottom of his nose. So the bottom of his nose, and it'll give you an idea. It'll help when you come to place the nose, the features on the face. That's your first clue. Now it's not just a circle, it's a sphere. Now this character is pretty much in profile, so we're just going to get a little hint of that line coming down there and then across that chin. The next thing I'm looking at is I'm looking at where the top of his head is, and I'm trying to figure out where the bottom of his chin is going to go. Once I've got the top of his head and the bottom of his chin, and we already know where the bottom of his nose is going to go, if I took a line halfway in between those is going to roughly give me where the where his eye sits, the line that his eye sits on. So I'm going to pop that eyeball. I'm not going to draw the just the eye itself. So I imagine the eyeball behind it. And then I'm going to create a slight box shape for his jaw. Now that jawline, if you have a look very carefully, that jawline runs up and it runs just in front of the ear, and the ear sits behind it on the back half of the head. So when you're looking at a head in profile, make sure that that ear runs off the back of that jawline on the back half of the head. The other thing you can sort of take note of is where his eyebrow is, and just run that contour line around that sphere, and that'll pretty much tell you where the top of his ear goes. And the bottom of his nose, if you do the same thing, will give you the bottom of his earlobe. And that pretty much dictates where that ear is going to go. So I'm just putting a simple sort of oval shape in there. I'm just going to make it a little bit bigger. Get my pen working again. There we go. There. Once we've got that in, pretty much got the roughed out idea of where his head's going to go. I want to think about where his body, where his upper torso is going. Now this is a pretty much a portrait that we're drawing here, and we can't see all of it, but I want to get that rib cage, that upper body. Now that upper body is going to be shaped like an ovoid. So it's a sphere, but it's drawn out in an elliptical ovoid shape. So I'm drawing, and then you draw right through it, right around to where it wraps around at the back of the neck. I'm just going to bring that over a bit. Make that a bit smaller, maybe. No, there we go, just a little bit. And then it's going to wrap around. Now I can see where his neck's going, and I can pretty much put in an oval shape where the head, the neck is going to connect to the top of his chest. And I can also see that's the pit of his neck, so that's that point in between his two collarbones, and that'll give me the center line for the chest. So I now know his chest is facing that direction. That's all my basic shapes in just there. Well, we might actually put in the cylinder for his neck as well, which connects at the back of his skull. There we go. I can see a bit of his shoulder there, so I'm just going to indicate that that's where his shoulder is. Okay. Now that's drawing from that picture. With my character, I want that neck and shoulder area to be much broader. I want this Captain Tiger to be quite a bullish, stocky guy. So let's just add some volume on to the back of the neck, quite a bit, and take that back area right up there now. So instantly I've changed him from a reasonable sort of guy into a much stockier guy. Remember, it's a cartoon. It doesn't have to be totally realistic, but I definitely want him stocky. Not quite Incredible Hulk, but still a little bit bigger than this character here. Just going to get the rubber out. There we go. And just take out a bit of that so that doesn't distract me from later on. Okay. I do want him wearing this same similar sort of collar shirt, so I quite like that. So we'll use that. And wrap that collar right around his neck there. I'll bring that shoulder down a little bit there. There we go. Now I want to simplify him quite a bit. I don't want all those wrinkles, nooks and crannies. After all, we're going to want to redraw this character over and over. We don't want to put too much detail in. We want to simplify everything. So let's start off, well, I'm going to put in the nose and just create almost a box shaped nose. I will put in that nostril, and when I'm drawing a nostril in, I don't do it as a circle or an oval, I do it pretty much as a number six on its side. So I want to put that in, and then I want to just give a nice 1, 2, 3 box shape around the wings of his nose, the wings of his nostril there. I do like this moustache with the chops on the side there. I think that looks really cool. So let's try that out. Now remember, this is just the experimental stage. You can change it at any point, but let's just get something down and see what we like. The idea is to sort of change your character around a little bit. Make the eyes bigger, the nose smaller or bigger, depending on what you're looking at. Just the same as if you're doing a caricature, you want to emphasize certain things and diminish certain others. Give him a simple square jaw. I want him to be quite a strong character. Oh, don't forget to put those in. It's mutton chops. There we go. Suddenly he's coming together. I do like the captain's hat, the sailor's hat here. So we'll do a simplified version of that. Coming around. And we've got a band there. I want to keep that in. And the peak. We want to simplify the shape just a little bit. There we go. Keep it nice and simple, nice and clear. Particularly with the hair, we don't want to get into drawing individual hairs with spaghetti hair. So we want to draw big clumps or ribbons of hair as we come down. So just break it into 2 or 3 parts. Keep mixing it up a bit. Something like that. And I'll get that rubber again and just take out a little bit smaller. Yeah, that so it looks like the hair is going over, it's overlapping the ear. Alright, coming back to the eye, we've already put the eyeball in. Now we just want to wrap the eyelid and the eyelashes around the eyeball and put that iris in. I'll keep his eyes a little bit bigger than what I see in the photo, but not huge. I don't want him to get too carried away. Maybe we give him one line underneath the eye. And then I just want to finish off by just putting in a hint of that eyebrow poking out from under that cap there. There we go. Now I've got something that I can work with. It's not exactly right just yet, but by progressing it, drawing over it, maybe making eyes bigger, smaller, but by varying things up, eventually I'll come up with a reasonable character. Let's move on to the next step. So remember, do a little bit of research, find some reference materials, draw from those reference materials, and then start changing it up, mixing it up a little bit. Find those shapes that you're looking for, simplify things into simple shapes, and your character will start developing from there. Okay, what have I got? Let's get rid of our captain for a second. Okay, now I'll show you this. This is part of my original concept work. When I first thought of the idea of the captain, I was thinking about the different shapes of different heads that we can use for our characters. Every shape that you draw, let's just grab another level here. Okay, so different shapes speak to us differently. So if you're drawing a very rounded shaped person or character, you're going to get a very well balanced, all rounded person. You think in terms of Mickey Mouse or something like that. Very happy, very jolly, very nice, cute sort of character. If you're drawing somebody with more of a triangular head, that person's got a lot of angles, sharp angles and solid lines. So that tends to mean that they're quick, usually quick-witted. They're very, they're usually smart if the triangle head's wide up the top, means they've got a lot of brains in there. So think of something like that brainiac guy off the movie. this a character called Invader Zim. He's a cute little guy, but he's wanting to take over the world. So he's a little bit evil, but he's very quick thinking. And quite often you get a lot of villains with this shape head. If you think of Jafar from the original Aladdin movie, he's got a very triangular head, especially with his hat on. And then you've got, more of a box-shaped head. Now, this is kind of where I'm coming to with my captain here. More of a box, squared-off head. Now, this sort of character is usually considered your tough character. Big jaw, squared-off head, tough character. Shoulders sort of leaning over like that. And we're creating a much more tough, sort of solid, dependable sort of character. It can be a tough guy, it can be a bad guy, but not necessarily. But it's got to be, it will be big and tough, nevertheless. So you've got those sort of different shapes that you can try. There are other ones, for instance, you can actually use a cylinder. One, as they did with Bart Simpson. But there are all sorts of different shapes that you can use. Each one of them will sort of help you describe your character. But I wanted pretty much that squared off box shaped head for my character. So I drew what we call a turnaround. So I start off and I just thought, okay, I want him with that square shape. And I just drew that in as a front on look at him. And I put him some eyes. I know that he had a broken sort of Roman nose, very much my father had he played rugby and had his nose broken a few times, so he had that very broken look. Wanted that same sort of look for him. So we gave him that broken nose there. Just going to bring that up a bit closer so we can see it clear. There we are. And that's the first thing that we want to do is start just throwing something down. It's kind of like throwing a lump of clay down. It gives us something to play with. I knew I wanted him to have a moustache. So I put the moustache in. Gave him just some little teacup ears for a start. And just a bit of a cowlick. Some eyebrows. That was my original idea for the captain. Right there. Really simple. But also very two-dimensional and not very satisfying. So I knew I wanted a little bit more. So that's when I went and did the research and discovered that photo of the captain, which I brought over here. And I put it on top of these expressions that I've done with my captain. Just 1 second to find where I put those. There we go. Now I'm starting to get a little bit closer. So once I sort of went back, put on the captain's hat, that visor coming around, I made sure that he had that very definite broken nose with that number 6 on the side. I made his eyes a little bit bigger, but not too big. Didn't want to get too carried away with the cartoon aspect, but I really loved that big moustache that went right off the side of his face there and those mutton chops on the side, and I gave them a definite shape as well. And I also brought in that shirt. Remember I mentioned that I quite like the look of that shirt? I gave him that shirt. And once I got this guy here, I thought, all right, that's pretty close to what I want. So that's kind of basically the steps you want to go through. Once you get to sort of that sort of point, then you can come back and you can start doing what I was doing up here, that turnaround. First start off with the head, get a straight on view of your character, then go to a 3/4, which is pretty much what I've drawn there. So I'm going to grab my way out here. pretty much what I've drawn. That's why, it's not the wrong thing. Yeah, I've got my pen. Pretty much what I've drawn here. So that's a three quarter, although it does have an expression on it. So you get a front on, a profile, a three quarter, and as I've seen with some model sheets, a rear view as well. Once you've got those different perspectives of your character, usually just within a neutral expression, then you go through and start putting some expressions on. Start off by making him look as I did over here. Let's bring it up. This one here where he's looking. Oh, a little bit surprised. And this one here, I was thinking about that sort of surprise, but when I drew it, I thought, oh my God, he looks like he's singing. But I left it in. I thought, hey, maybe I could bring that in as part of the story. And this is where you do, as you start developing your character and putting expressions in, you may get little story ideas and ideas that you might want to put in your book or your animation. Then I wanted to give him a big smug smile. I wanted that moustache to go up and be part of that smile. So I brought that look in there. Then I wanted him to look a little bit more angry. I've got his tongue sticking outside. I'm not sure what I was thinking there. But I wanted to try experimenting with that angry look. And I can see now I could probably push that a lot further, you know, and really sort of bring those eyebrows in and really get a much more angrier look here. This one down here, he's looking rather nervous and worried. This one, he looks a much more neutral, sort of happy. Yeah, I've heard some good news, and he's smiling. And I think I was just trying to advance that whole idea of singing down there. So once you get a few ideas like that, then you might want to sort of start developing that idea. And I started putting them into the pose of basically an opera singer going like that, just as an idea to play with. Don't know if I'll use it, but hey, we keep playing with it. Okay, once I got the head, then I wanted to think about his proportions in their entirety. I'll just move that along, make that a bit smaller, too small, come back. There we go. My Wacom tablet's playing up. Okay, now the thing to remember too, when we're designing characters, and this is true if you're drawing from life, if you're drawing from a model, or if you're drawing a character, we always measure our characters in how many head highs they are. So we break our characters into how many heads high. An average male is about 7.5 to 8 heads high. So just remember, 8 heads high. Female, 7 to 7.5 heads high. Now, our character is a cartoon, so he's not going to be so realistic. He's going to have a slightly larger head, and if you give somebody a larger head, you tend to make them look more like a younger person and therefore make them a little bit cuter. So a larger head, and he's going to have short legs. Okay, so how many heads high? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 heads high. So he's actually got the proportions of a 5, 6, 7-year-old child. But much bigger with shorter legs. Okay. So have a think about proportions. Think about what sort of audience you're trying to reach. Is it a more sophisticated teenage audience, adult audience, or is it younger children? For in this one, I'm thinking I want this to be aimed more at around the tens, maybe sort of 8, 9, 10, 11, 12-year-olds. So I'm trying to keep them reasonably cute in that respect. But still, look, I want to maintain that tough look as well. Yeah, let's grab that. So that's what I've done. So I've kept his head reasonably large compared to a portion of his body, and I've made him only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 heads high. Now, with his body shape, I always break it into two. I'm thinking of that rib cage, as I talked about when we're drawing from the reference material. There's an ovoid shape for the rib cage. I want to get that first. When I'm thinking about the hips, I'm thinking more of a box shape, and that box sort of rolls forward slightly, and then it rounds off a little bit at the back, maybe not that much, I don't know. And then I'll draw that center line down there, so I know that's which way he's facing. And once I've got that, then I can add on maybe a sphere for the shoulder and cylinders for the upper arm, cylinders for the forearm, and I'll just do a simple round shape for the hand at this point. So I can only see a little bit of the sphere over that side for the shoulder, a little bit of the cylinder for the arm, a little bit of cylinder for the lower arm, and again I'll just put in a circle shape for the palm of his hand. The legs I'm keeping quite short, and the feet very, very small. So again, cylinders for the legs, but they sort of angle up as they're attached to the hips. And we'll give them very little feet, just nice round feet. Once you've got all those pieces in, that basic clay that you've thrown down, that's when you can come back over and start adding in all the details. Like I've got his sleeves rolled up, and yet I still want him to sort of be thinking that he's got one of those warm vests under, so he's got a shirt with long sleeves under it. So he's rolled up his sleeves. So I'm just putting in those cuffs there. I want him to have a big buckle on his belt, and I want to maybe put cuffs on his trousers as well. And I just keep it to one button on his shirt, just to indicate that it is a button-up shirt. Don't want to put in too many little details, especially if it goes to animation and you're putting all those buttons in. Every time that you draw that character, you're going to have to put those buttons in over and over again, and they will tend to wander a little bit sometimes. So that's the basis. Once you've got your character drawn like that, then you go back, make sure you do a front arm, do the three quarter like you're seeing here, and a profile at least, and maybe a back view just to finish off. Let's have a look. Did I do some more? There we go. There's my front on version of them. I think the front on version needs a little bit of work, but at least I've got it down, and then I can start playing with it from there. Right. Before we go, I'll just show you one other small one that I've been doing. Let's see if I can find it. That might be it. Okay. Let's back to the captain. Okay, bear with me for just 1 second. Here we go. This is something else I wanted to show you. Okay, before we move on from the captain, when you are doing the turnaround, it's very useful to bring some lines. I usually use a different color so that shows up, and I've used green here, and I just bring up a line across the top so that as I'm drawing my character in the turnarounds, they line up so that the head's not going to start changing dimensions and start changing his character. So everything should line up. The belt should line up, the bottom of the chin should line up, the nose should line up, where the hands end should line up. Everything should line up. So use those lines, those horizontal lines, to line up where everything goes, and you'll just keep your character in that proportion. Anyway, I hope that helps. Have a play around. By all means, play around drawing the captain, and we'd love to see your work so I can have a look at it too. So you'll find a link to a Facebook page here at Lake House Arts. Please message us or email us at that at the website. The website is, let me remember, it is www.lakehousearts.org.nz. Love to hear from you. Give us a call. I'm just going to stop sharing now and then I'll end the recording.